Following the dozens of sexual harassment charges leveled against him, Minister of State and External Affairs MJ Akbar has finally resigned from his post today. In a statement that he put out soon after, he said that since he's seeking justice in a court of law and is looking to clear his name in a personal capacity, he thus decided to step down. Akbar was referring to a defamation case he had filed against Priya Romani, one of the women who had accused him of sexually harassing her. Expressing her relief at Akbar's resignation, Romani on social media said that she felt vindicated and looked forward to seeking justice in a court of law. Another survivor, Ghazala Wahab, also said that she was hugely relieved after the minister's resignation and said that it doesn't matter whose mind is behind whom, eventually it's the truth that prevails. Today marks a historic day as Kerala's Sabarimala temple finally opened its gates to all its devotees at 5 p.m. But instead of celebrations, all we've heard since the morning is violence, clashes and chaos marking the areas around the temple as protesters created pandemonium to prevent the women from entering the temple. A special target of the protesting mobs seems to be female journalists. Considering that within a span of 2 to 3 hours, female reporters from the News Minute, Republic TV and CNN News 18 were attacked and required police protection. Now, despite the state government promising the safety of all the women visiting the temple, are they really doing enough to protect them? Where are the barriers to prevent the protesters from raging on? Why are there enough officials at the spot to protect the female media personnel who are only trying to do their job? The state government has promised that the Supreme Court order will be implemented. But so far, they haven't seemed to take any real action against the protesters, at least enough to make them leave the women in peace. India's Me Too movement has taken off, with allegations against celebrated individuals emerging on an almost daily basis now. Just yesterday, Manto director Nandita Das's father, Jatin Das, who is a noted painter and a Padma Bhushan awardee, was called out for having sexually harassed a woman 14 years ago. While her father rubbished the claims, Nandita Das, however, reiterated her support for the movement. In another case, another woman, this time a model, has called out author Suhail Seth for allegedly shoving his tongue down her throat at a party. Pujo shomoy mangsho ar fish fry na khele chole na ki? If you're also a die-hard, one-directional, non-vegetarian Bengali like me, then you know that you're definitely going to get a shock on the weighing scale after these 5 days of unapologetic meat indulgence. As a treat for you, we got together two food enthusiasts, radio jockey Aditya Kaushal and home culinary and travel enthusiast Ayandrali Datta, to prepare some of the best Bengali dishes to liven up your pujo.
So the fresh bhetki that we just got from the market, mm-hmm. we need to marinate them with a nice portion of the coriander and ginger and little garlic paste.
And salt.
Don't forget the salt. Yes, it's nice and actually crackling the fish.
Yeah. Egg or breadcrumbs ki jo layer hai, that's solidifying into a yeah. golden layer of crispy.
World.
Under the Yogi Adityanath government, the name of the city of Allahabad has been shifted to Prayagraj, and people aren't happy about it. Their argument? With a new name comes a new legacy. So what about the decades-long legacy that comes with Allahabad? Is it to be another page to be turned and forgotten? Watch the Queen's Mekhla express her ire at the name change in this powerful poem.
You can mess with the country's memory all you like, but leave my town's history aside. Ditch your attempt to alienate and ostracize, make people forget and Hinduize. Hundreds like me will feel homeless, because home is the memory, home is the name. You'll render me an outsider, my land strange, in an attempt to win this game. You may scribble a twisted history, but Prayagraj ain't my home. Mr. Chief Minister, I beg you, leave my Allahabad alone.
Kuch kuch hota hai yaar, tum nahi samjhoge. It's been 20 years since Rahul friendzoned Anjali to be with Tina, only to later fall in love with Anjali, who FYI loved him the entire time. Kids after the 90s, you'll never understand the Rahul Anjali handshake, Anjali's iconic headband, or the symbolism of the basketball court. Be right back, I got a binge. To stay updated with the latest news, log in and subscribe to our website, The Quint.